In this session, we are going to see in the system the wastewater structure in EWM. First of all, we are going to start by the ECC or by the ERP structure, and we are going to go down until we reach the storage bin that we have seen in the in our overview. So first of all, we are going to go to the configuration, to the customizing. And here we are going to see that for ECC, we have this enterprise structure menu where we can see the definition. And here we are going to define the different elements, organizational units. These activities are going to be done before the go live, during the implementation of a brand new or a rollout of SAP and SAP implementation, and they are going to remain there normally without many changes. Maybe in the future it is decided to create a new store allocation or to add a plant if a new facility is bought, but normally they are going to be quite stable data. So for instance, here we could define the plants, the different plants that we are going to use. As we remember in the overview, each plan is going to be a location, a different location where we have a facility. It could be a distribution center, it could be a factory. So as you see here, we can have different ones. These are going to be related to the different company codes, if we have different companies in the same organization. And for each of them, we are going to be able to see the detail where we have the description and we have the address and some basic data. So here is where we would define different plants. In the materials management menu, we can define the different store allocations. These are store allocations in inventory management in ECC. Still, we are not talking about extended warehouse management. We even are not talking about WM. So here, for instance, for this plant, we have these store allocations. Okay, so we can define different store allocations for the same plant. The same as before, we can, for each of them, we can see, we can add different addresses, and we have, as you see, very basic information of this organizational structure. We have as well this logistics execution. This is the WM functionality for ECC, but it's also needed for implementing EWM. So here, you see we have this defined warehouse number where we can enter and define the different warehouse numbers. These are warehouse number of ECC, but they are going to be needed because they are linked to the materials. And this is the link that we are going to use for linking them to the EWM warehouse number. So it is a different object. This is the warehouse number in ECC, and we are going to see now the warehouse number in EWM, but they are linked and they have the same function. The main reason why we are maintaining two different objects is that the beginning EWM was a different application, a different program that it was maintaining a different, even in a different server. And for instance, they had different warehouse numbers, but they were linked together. So this was the way of linking them. Now they are going to work with S/4HANA in the same program, in the same application, but still the same architecture is maintained. So we need to maintain this warehouse number, as this is going to be the organizational unit for our master data in ECC. And we're going to see now how we connect this to the EWM warehouse number. So this would be for the definition. Then we have this assignment menu where we would assign, first of all, we would assign, well, in the store allocations were already assigned to the plants, and we are going to assign the warehouse number, this is the WM warehouse number that we have just seen, to the plant and store allocation. So, as we saw in the overview, We can have for the different plat different store locations, and we can assign the same warehouse number to more than one. We could assign just the warehouse number to one store location, one to one, or we could assign the warehouse number to more than one store locations. In this case, you see for this plan, US01, we have two store locations, USFS and USRD, and we have assigned to both of them the same warehouse number, US1. So this would be how these ECC organizational units are created, and we are going to see now how we are going to link them to EWM. First of all, we see we have here the Extended Warehouse Management menu. This is the functionality of Extended Warehouse Management that is now included in the ECC functionality because we are in S4HANA and it is added to the code, to the core. And here, as you see, we have different options. And the first of all is in the master data, we have defined warehouse number. So here is where we would define the warehouse number for EWM. As you see, this is a 4-character code, so it is different. So it's different to the EWM, to the WM code. And apart from that, we have some specific description. Of course, we have a different description than the one in the, we can have a different description than the one in WM. So we are going to see now where these two warehouse numbers are integrated. We have this menu.